Good morning, children, and welcome to the EVS class. So, children, how are you all? I hope you are all good and taking good care of yourself and also attending the online classes regularly. Okay, children? So, children, shall we start our EVS class? Okay. So, children, before we begin with the lesson, shall we all take out the EVS 2 textbook? Okay. So, children, all of you take out your EVS 2 textbook, and as we all know, we are doing which lesson? We are doing lesson number 5, that is water, water everywhere. And today we'll finish off the lesson. We are almost to the end of the lesson, and today we'll finish it off. Okay, so before we go to the lesson, what is today's date, children? Today's date is 19th of August 2020. Already 18 days have passed and we are in the 19th day. So children, shall we do a recap? You remember what we did in the last class? Yes, we learned about fresh water, tap water and salty water. And what is fresh water? The water that we get from rivers, ponds, and streams and wells and so on are called fresh water. And we use this fresh water for drinking, bathing, fishing and cooking. And what is salty water, children? The water which we get in the seas and oceans. We cannot use this water. And this water is called salty water. And then, children, what is tap water? Okay, what is tap water, children? Again, tap water in cities. People use tap water. Okay, we use tap water. Tap water comes from wells, ponds, rivers, lakes. From anything they come to our homes, but they come through taps. Okay, children, I hope you remember. Then, children, we go to the next part, which we did in the last class. What did we do, children? We studied in villages may use tap water. Okay, tap, because in villages tap water is not much available. They directly go to rivers, streams or lakes and they get water from there, or they use hand pumps. But children, do you think it is safe to get water from wells, rivers, streams and to drink water from it? No, because what it has germs. The water may look clean, but it contains germs, dirt or mud in it. Okay, now what are germs? These are germs. Okay, these scary, see, it looks so scary, children. This is germs. See, this water, it looks so perfectly clean, but under an instrument, okay, it's called magnifying glass, or under microscope, these germs you can see in water, okay. And these germs, they cause infection to our eyes. We suffer from many diseases due to germs in water. And so what we should do, children, in order to get rid of the germs, we should boil water. Okay, we should boil water or filter water. So this was the recap that we did. This was a quick recap of what we did in the last class. Okay, children. Now, children, all of you take out this page. This is the last portion of the textbook. And what it is given here, you can see some picture of some women and some girls. And what they are doing, they are carrying some utensils on their head. And you know what these utensils have? It has water. These are village women. And what they do? Let's see. All of you ready with your textbook? Okay. People in the olden days made houses near the water sources because there were no taps, wells or hand pumps. Only natural sources of water were there. So before, there were no taps, okay, children, neither wells or hand pumps, only streams and then rivers were there, and people didn't know how to make these taps and wells and hand pumps also in the olden days, before. Now what people used to do, they used to stay near sources of water only. They used to stay near rivers, streams, etc. Then what happened? Then they started building artificial sources like wells, taps and pipelines. Then slowly, these human beings, they started learning to make wells, taps and pipelines. Okay, children. Then what happened? Today also, And some places have very few sources of water. In these places, everyday people walk to faraway places to get water for daily use. Water is not easily available for them. Now children, today also many people, they don't get water from taps. And what they do, they stay near these sources of water only. They make their houses near these sources of water, like river, stream. They used to stay there, okay? And in some places, what they used to do, they have to walk for far away places, okay, where the water is very scarce, there is not enough water. Some people have to walk to that place where water is there. They have to carry water in the utensils, and then they have to carry back to their home. And here you can see a picture has been shown. Children, can you see a picture of women carrying water in their utensils, which they carry in their head? They travel from their home to the source of water. They carry the water in these utensils, then they come back to their homes. Then they start cooking, washing, and whatever they have to do. So the children, isn't this very tiresome and very hard work they do? So children, we should not waste water, isn't it? We should not waste water, because water is very precious. In our homes, we get enough water. Water comes every day. But in some places, people have to go, they have to walk to long distances to get water. So children, with this, we come to the end of the lesson. Now let's see what is some more. Here you can see, children, English fun is the two rhyming words you have to write. Okay. Now children, this will be for your homework. Okay, write two rhyming words for each. Rain, you can write main, then one more you can write tain, then well, then you can write rhyming words. You can write hell, H-E-L-L, then you can write bell, B-E-L-L, okay, hell, you can write bell, you can write. Okay, rhyming words. What are rhyming words? Rhyming words, the pronunciation is same, but their spellings are a bit different. Okay, the first letter is changed, but the other spellings remain same. The rain, main is there. Okay, then you can find tain. Or you can write one more word, you can write here, it is plain. Okay, and lake, you can write make, then take. Okay, so this will be for your homework. I have shown you, now you do for homework. Okay children, and then maths fun, you have to, what you have to do, you know, count the letters in each word, write the number name. Now you have to count the letters. How many are there? Fresh water, how many letters are there? F1, R2, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. So you'll have to write the number name. You don't have to write like this 0, 1, 0. No, you'll have to write, children, what number name? You'll have to write 10. Okay, then rainwater. How many letters are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. You'll have to write 9. Now children, this will be for your homework. Okay children, and so children, with this we come to the end of the lesson. Both this homework, the English fun and the maths fun, you'll do for homework, and you will submit it in your Google Classroom. I hope you all have joined. So with this we come to the end of the lesson. In the next class, I'll do children some workbook questions. Okay, then we'll do the workbook questions. So children, till then, have a good day, and bye bye, and take care. Bye bye.